politics has kind of been one thing that I rarely ever talked about on my channel. But now I'm a canvasser, and I'm going to Colorado campaigning for Obama. So I guess now's the time to kind of start talking a little bit about politics. I guess I won't talk too much. I mean, it is a topic that does get people inflamed and mad. But an important thing to know is that I'm pretty damn liberal. And, like, really liberal. Like, Democratic Party is not liberal enough for me. That's one of the things, you know, yeah. On a lot of different things, I'm very liberal. There are some things, I guess, I am more conservative or libertarian on. Like, for example, during the Republican presidential nominee debates, whatever, Ron Paul was talking about that America shouldn't be doing foreign aid at all. And I'm on board with that, you know, and that's a very libertarian view. That is not a progressive view, what liberals like to call themselves. So, you know, because foreign aid, according, you know, with the progressive view, would be, you know, helping out those countries that are kind of doing poorly with money. But I really, you know, I'm with Ron Paul on that issue, simply because when we send money to those poor countries, Ron Paul is right. We are giving money to the richest people in poor countries. So we're not really helping them that much. My stance as a social work major graduate is that if you want to help foreign countries like that, we need to do it with activism and volunteer work. And advocacy, not through money. Although money is what funds those organizations that go in there. So it's more about funding the people that go in there rather than funding the actual countries and people in the countries themselves. Anyway, that's a whole other topic. But I guess I want to talk about the fact that I'm going to canvass for Obama. It's interesting because I am not a huge fan of the Obama administration. There's been a lot of different things that Obama administration has done that's just like, whoa, this is something that even Bush wouldn't have done. You know, this is like craziness. You know, the doubling or tripling of drone strikes, for one. The, I forgot the acronym, but, you know, the law, which is now deemed unconstitutional recently, but what was it, like this New Year's Eve or something like that, I think December 31st, you know, Obama secretly, like, the administration and Congress kind of under our noses passed this law that can kill any U.S. citizen that the president deems as a threat to national security. Craziness. Bush would, even that didn't even... Oh, craziness, you know, and the bailout of banks. I know the president drums up the talk of the auto bailout, and then saving the auto industry. But yeah, on that issue, like, you know, he used taxpayer money to help corporations. So with Obama, there has been a lot of corporatocracy, you know. I think he's been the most corporate-friendly president ever, like, and that's the thing, because the you know, places like Fox News labels him as a socialist, as anti-business. I don't know what they're seeing, but that's not what I'm seeing. So yeah, it's interesting to canvass for a president who I don't fully support. But the thing about American politics, at least with presidential elections, is that we're not really given a choice. We're given a dilemma, not a choice. If I was given a choice, you know, and if I could vote, I can't vote. I'm a permanent resident, not a U.S. citizen, so I don't have the right to vote in this country. But if I could vote, you know, I'm not actually sure if I would vote for Obama. But I would have to, because I don't want Romney to win. Romney is, I guess, on paper, on theory, He's worse than, like, not worse per se, but everything, all my values that I believe in, Romney kind of is the, like, not opposite or doesn't believe in that. He goes against so many things that I politically believe in. And Obama, while he doesn't feel there, he's not, like, super opposed to it. Like, okay, the Romney ticket, he's actually moderate on an issue like abortion. He's moderate because the vice president of Knesset, Paul Ryan, believes that, you know, abortions should be illegal. The only exception is if the mother's life is in danger. It doesn't matter if the woman was raped, doesn't matter, whatever. You know, that's the only exception that Paul Ryan has. So pretty extreme view, pretty rightist view on abortion. And I'm sure, you know, there are Republicans and conservatives who feel that way. But that's really, really right. That's like super conservative. In a political spectrum of right and left, that's like way up here on that issue. And I guess Romney is just like one step here, but he's considered as a moderate, which is just crazily bizarre if you ask me. So, yeah, like that's just one thing. And of course, this election to me feels a lot more important than a lot of times before, simply because, you know, it's just considering the fact that two of the Supreme Court justices are, you know, pretty close to retiring. They're over 70 years old. Who knows how long they can last out. I was talking with my friend yesterday, and she was like, well, you know, if Romney does win, I bet those two Supreme Court justices would make, like, do everything they can to not retire, because they believe strong, like, you know, they're in the positions where they're so politically involved. But I don't know. I mean, that's kind of tough to have to like stick to the job way beyond the point you're retiring simply because there's a president whose values are a complete opposite of yours. But yeah, that's the thing. There isn't a choice in America. I'm going back to that point because I digress so much. There isn't a choice. If I could vote, if I was a U.S. citizen and I could vote, and there's also a big another if. If third parties actually mattered, like if they were viable to win, yeah, I mean, I wouldn't be voting for Obama. I'll be voting for this election, I'd probably vote for Jill Stein on the Green Party ticket. That's who I would vote for. But the thing is, that if is not there. Jill Stein, there's not a chance in hell that she would win. And for you libertarians out there, there's not a chance in hell that Gary Johnson would win. This election is not voting for candidates. It's not voting for who we believe in. It's one of the most cynical elections ever. It's voting against candidates. As I canvass for Obama, I'm not thinking, well, I'm getting people to vote for Obama. That would be my job. But personally, my justification is, you know, I'm hoping that Romney doesn't win. That's like, I'm voting against Romney. A lot of the Romney supporters, I mean, Romney has made so many goop, like, gaps and, I don't know, off-the-wall comments that are just, you know, just, I don't even know, like, if people were voting for Romney, I don't know, I feel like that would be hard to find. Same thing with Obama. I feel like it'd be a lot harder now, having experienced Obama's administration for 4 years, if there would be a lot of Obama supporters. You know, it's tough. It's like a Bush versus Kerry thing. Who was actually voting for Kerry? Who was actually voting for Bush? Like, right? No, people are voting against candidates. And that's what I'm doing. That's what I'm voting against. Well, I'm not actually voting, but I'm promoting to vote against Romney. And that's my political stance on this issue. It's just unfortunate that the American political system doesn't give you a choice. It gives you a dilemma, you know, but we have to make the best of it that we can. So, I mean, I still encourage people, politically informed people to vote their values. And if that value lies in with the third party, go for it. It's really unfortunate that third party is probably not going to win, but go for it. Your vote still does matter, even if the candidate is not elected. And it's really the Congress that makes the big difference anyway. So, you know, But for people who actually are realistic and cynical, you have to vote against the candidate that you hate the most, the more. So it's not voting for a candidate, you know. If whatever values you believe in, if you think Obama is the opposite of that, vote for Romney. If you know, if you're like me and whatever values you believe in, it's like Romney represents the opposite, then vote against Romney and vote for Obama. That's kind of the political situation in America, which is kind of unfortunate because it's heralded as like the most democratic nation in the world, when in a lot of cases it's kind of not.